Hello everybody, welcome for two new episodes of DIYC. In today's episode we'll be reviewing a new micro camera from Foxeer Razor Micro sent me by Banggood to review. And the really nice thing about this camera is that it weighs only 5 grams and gives you a lot better video quality than an all-in-one FPV camera where we can compare it with. You also need a VTX 5.8 GHz to transmit the video signal to your FPV receiver and screen, of course. But the nice thing about this little camera is it comes supplied with this OSD setting changer. So you can change a lot of settings of this little camera, as like the exposure, the lens aperture, the shutter speed and the brightness, the white balance. You can also change it from day to night settings, where you can change it from color to black and white, so you can even fly during the night. And then you can change the contrast, the sharpness, the saturation to get the best image video quality out of this little camera. Settings and see how good it works. It says up, down, left, right, so the middle will be probably enter. Oh, it's really hard. Oh, let me change out the settings, turn it black. Oh, we can change the brightness, exposure mode, so manually global center. Let's go down. Okay, now we can change it manually on automatic. Let's remove the lens again. Look, now we have some full control of the HU and we can change the colors to a more nicer and warm color. This looks more realistic for what I am seeing. Enter, return, and we can change from color automatic or black and white. That's for during the night. Just let it set auto, return, and it's exchanger. So now we can change out the contrast. I got really shaky hands. So. Maximum contrast, sharpness. Let's set it to manual. Well, it seems like on soft, the quality of the video looks better instead of really sharp. Saturation, well, let's change it also to manual. Look, already looking a lot better on manual. Oversaturation is absolutely no good. Yeah, 14 is nice. And let's see what this is. 3DNR. And then we have 2DNR. Into home, we get video settings, HD, and then we can change from PAL to NTS, but I'm in Europe, so we're using PAL. You get also better resolution on PAL. And one thing that I forgot to tell you is that the camera comes in two modes, 4x3 and 16x9, so you can use the full screen of your FPV monitor, the 16x9 that I like, because I'm using the full screen. Or using 4x3, this is a little bit smaller, but it's used for your FPV goggles. So if you're flying with FPV goggles, then you would like to have the 4.3 version of this camera. Changing the settings did really work, because the video quality really improved a lot better. Blue is nicely blue, the E58 is nice and grey, and the Foxeer box is still nice and red. We are ready to give this video camera a go. Put it on a plane and let's go outside and have a flight.
Here we are, we got a Foxeer Razor Micro FPV camera on the back with the VTX.
Okay, ready for takeoff. Second test flight.
So nice, high in the sky, looking into the sun. Hear a plane, it's always wise to go low and to fly low. Maybe do even a touch and go. Woohoo! Yeah, baby. Need some action. Come on, don't crash. Keep on flying. Battery is getting half empty, of course. So. Yeah, I can hear the motors falling down slowly. Time to come in and land. Woohoo! Alright, next to all the FPV equipment. That was a close call. And yes, I'm on a bicycle. Typical Dutch, we love bicycles, we got plenty of bicycles. We got 3, 4, 5 bicycles per person for each person in the entire Holland. Almost 50, 60 million bikes, and we're only with 16 or 17 million people in this little small country that is as flat as a dime. Yep. That was a great test flight. I'm not gonna try to push it any further. I'm gonna go back home and check out the video footage behind the video editor.
And seeing the footage right here in my video editor and compared with my all-in-one FPV camera, this little camera from Foxeer Razor is just 10 times better. And it weighs the same, but it was sharper, I had more details, it could handle looking straight into the sun without being blasted away. I was able to see the ground and the sky at the same time without anything getting black. It was an amazing good quality for the same price as an all-in-one FPV camera. You will find the links down below. And there's one more test that we want to do, of course, and that's the latency test.
And how good this camera works during the light, looking into the bright sun, looking down on the nice ground, looking over the water that is completely calm like a mirror, is gonna be beautiful. Well, let's see.